Hi everybody, welcome to today's coffee break. This is the first in two coffee breaks about setting up subcontractors to use in manufacturing, and our second one will be actually using them in the manufacturing process. So the first thing we need to do are a series of setups in order to be able to do this. Once you've done the setups, everything works really well. But we need to make sure we do our setups right. So what we're going to do is we're going to create a location that will be for our vendor. That way when we send components to them, to our subcontractor, we can actually see that they exist at that vendor's location. And then we're going to create a general product posting group. Because we have a new location, we need to point it towards the proper GL accounts. Then we're going to create a parent item and a component item. And then we're going to put everything onto a work center and a routing. I know it sounds confusing, but it's not, so let's go. So the first thing we need to do is set up that location. So I'm going to go to departments and warehouse and administration and locations. So what I've done here is I've got all my standard division locations. I've got a blue location, which is my production warehouse. And down here, I have my vendor's location. So what I've done is I've created a location with a V as a prefix just so that I know that that's a subcontractor. I know it's my vendor. And then I've used my vendor's code as well. And I have a little name here. They're my wood stainer. Now, of course, on that vendor card, let's go ahead and edit it. You can put any information that you want about that vendor. So I have their name and their location. And again, because I've used that prefix V, when I'm printing reports, it's very easy for me to filter to exclude my vendor locations or to include my vendor locations, all right? Because they're sort of going to be grouped together with all those V prefixes. So once that's set up, I'm going to go ahead and close this. I need to set up my general product posting group. And what I've done here is I have set up a different general product posting group for my subcontractors. Once that's done, you want to make sure that you complete the general posting setup for this new posting group. So I'm just going to go up here to setup. And of course, we need to map it to all the proper GL accounts. Just like you would have to do anytime you create a new location and a general product posting group, you need to link all that together, and this is where we do that. All right, so now that that's done, we get to the fun stuff. Let's go to the parent item. And I have a number of items here. I have my finished good, which is my stained wood, and then I have two components. I have the wood and the wood stain. So this is my parent item. I'm going to go ahead and open this up. So one of the things that I want to point out on the parent item is that we've got down here our replenishment system will be a production order. And of course, I've got my routing and my production bomb on my parent item. Right, so that's not really tricky. That's pretty standard. So what we want to do, though, is go to the stock keeping unit, and that's where things get a little bit more tricky. So I'm going to go up here to navigate stock keeping units. And my stock keeping unit for this particular parent item is my production location, which is my blue location. So let's just open this up. And what I want to point out here is that my replenishment system on the SKU is production order, right? Because that's how it gets created. But what's really interesting here is my components. So my components exist at that new vendor location that we've created. All right, so that's what's kind of unique about the parent item. Let's go ahead and close this, and let's go look at the component. So if we compare that to our component, we go down here, and our replenishment system is purchased because we purchased our components. We don't make them, right? And of course, this is the vendor that we purchased them from. And again, I'm going to take a look at that stock keeping unit. And this is where things get interesting. So the component is at this vendor location. All right, let's just open this up. And the replenishment system is going to be transfer. All right, so that's what's, there's a difference here in the setups between the parent item and the components. And the reason that we do that is that eventually when we're processing this, we're going to automate the transfer of the components to that vendor's location so that we know where they are during the production process. The next thing we want to set up is in manufacturing. We're going to go ahead and set up a work center. Let's go to manufacturing. Okay. So I have a bunch of work centers that are vendor related. So I can set up multiple subcontractors with different work centers. You can also create a generic subcontractor if they change all the time, and then you can change it a little bit later on down the line. But I'm going to go ahead and set up a specific work center for this particular subcontractor. So again, I've used my prefixes V so that I know that this is a work center that is not in-house. This is not a work center within my production location blue. This is a vendor subcontractor. Once you've got it set up, you want to go down here to the unit cost calculation, and you want to select units. Typically, the way that vendors bill you for their production is by unit. You know, we produce this for this many units, this is the cost, rather than time like you would have on your production line. So we want to go ahead and select the unit cost calculation of units, and the specific unit cost will be checked. Then over here, we have our subcontractor number, and this is the actual vendor card. Right, this is the vendor number that I've pulled from my vendor list. So you see here that my vendor code is an extension on my work center. I use the same code so that I know who it is. Now down here I have a general product posting group of vendor subcontractor, and I like to do that because I like to be able to control my P&L and where the contracting costs go, which is what we did in the beginning when we set all that up with the location and the product posting groups. So now we've done that, we're going to set up a routing. Again, these routings are a little bit different than your standard routings that you would have for your production line at your blue warehouse. I'm going to open this up, and what I want to show you is that the routing number is the work center number that we've just created. All right. The wait time is 5 days, which is the time that it takes for this vendor, when they've got our components, this is how long it takes for them to turn it around. And the unit cost is the cost that they're charging us per unit that they produce. So when we, on the work center card, said that we wanted it to be that specific unit cost, when we check that box, that tells it to look here for the unit cost. Those are your basic setups. So again, you're going to be setting up your locations, your general product posting groups, and all the associated GL accounts. You're going to be pointing your parent items and your component items to the different, and their SKUs, to the different locations. And then you're going to set up your work center for the vendor, and you're going to point your routings to that vendor as well. That concludes our setup for the subcontractors.
Thanks for watching this ArcherPoint video. If you found it helpful, make sure to check out our website and blog at www.archerpoint.com. Additionally, if you have any questions regarding our products, services, or information in this video, feel free to email us at info@archerpoint.com. Thanks.